This lecture we are going to study about altruism that comes in behavior ecology. That's the part of CSI in our NET exam. So let's see what we are going to study in this lecture. First we are going to see its definition. In second part we are going to see Hamilton rule. Third one is we are going to see differences between altruism and natural selection, and fourth one we are going to see its reciprocal altruism, and fifth one is we are going to see kin selection. Okay, so let's see first of all what is altruism. So an organism is said to behave altruistically when its behavior benefits other organisms at a cost to himself. Altruistic behavior is common throughout the complex social structures. For example, warped monkeys. Now, how they behave altruistically, let's see. So these monkeys give alarm to warn fellow monkeys about the presence of predators. Even though in doing so they attract attention to themselves, increasing their personal chances of being attacked. Giving warning to their fellow monkeys, they are acting altruistically. Second example is vampire bats. They regularly collect blood and donate it to other members of their group who have been failed to feed that night, ensuring that they do not starve. So they are also acting altruistically. Third one is social insect colonies. In this example I have showed you social insect bees. Let's see how they behave altruistically. Because eggs are produced only by the queen, that is diploid and fertile, and fertilized by the males. Female workers devote their whole lives to caring for the queen, constructing and protecting the nest, foraging for food and tending the larva. Such behavior is maximally altruistic. Sterile female workers obviously do not leave any offspring of their own, so have a personal fitness of zero, but their action greatly assists the reproductive efforts of the queen. So how it is different from natural selection, let's see. Because natural selection leads us to expect animal to behave in ways that increase their own chances of survival and reproduction, not those of others. But behaving altruistically, an animal reduces its own fitness. As an above example, we have already talked about werewolf monkeys. They give alarm to warn fellow monkeys about the presence of predators. They are increasing their personal chances of being attacked. So we should expect natural selection to favor those monkeys that do not give alarm calls over those that do. Now we are going to see Hamilton's rules about inclusive fitness. And we can say that it is made up of two component: direct fitness by producing its own offspring, and second one is indirect fitness by providing aid that enables other close relatives who share many of those genes to produce offspring. So basically it is it's have two parts: direct fitness and second one is indirect fitness, you need to know. So Hamilton demonstrated that an altruistic gene will be favored by natural selection when a certain condition known as Hamilton rules is satisfied. So let's see what rules does it say. As you can see, R into B is greater than C. So what is C is here? C is the cost accrued by the altruistic animal, and B is benefit to recipient organism, and R is the coefficient of relatedness between donor and recipient, as we have already talked about werewolf monkeys. So a organism who are giving a alarm to their fellow monkeys. So that is the cost of it, of being chance to getting attacked it himself, while it is also benefiting to other fellow monkeys to save themselves from predators. So that is benefit to them. So we can reduce that to B. And R is coefficient of relatedness between donor and recipient. So higher the value of R, higher the possibility that recipient will also possess gene for altruism. So it is the Hamilton rules about inclusive fitness, you should know. Now let's see what is kin selection. So the natural selection that favor altruistically behavior by enhancing reproductive success of relative is called kin selection. So it is basically kin selection theory predict that animals are more likely to behave altruistically towards their relative than towards unrelated member of their species. So basically it is want to say to you that we obviously will help our relative more than unknown person. So it is also applying altruistic behavior. An organism will help their related organism first besides after unknown person. Now let's see reciprocal altruism. What does it say? It's theory given by Travers, and it explains this case among unrelated organisms, including different member of different species. In this, one thing is so much necessary that our organisms should interact with each more than once. They have to be meet. What is an example of reciprocal altruism? So a baboon may help an unrelated companion in a fight, or a wolf may offer food to another wolf even though they share no kinship. So this type of behavior can be adaptive if the added individual return the favor in the future. It will apply if the recipient of altruistic behavior would also give to the donor too. So it is very necessary that individuals should interact with each other more than once and have the ability to recognize other individuals with whom they have interacted in the past. If individuals interact only once in their lifetimes and never meet again, there is obviously no possibility of return benefit. So there is nothing to be gained by helping another. However, if individuals encounter each other frequently and are capable of identifying and punishing cheaters who have refused to help in the past, then the helping behavior can evolve. So this type of evolutionary mechanism is most likely to work where animals live in relatively small group, increasing the likelihood of multiple encounters. So this will be all for altruism.